In this series, we are learning how to do functional programming in JavaScript. You can find the full series by clicking there. In the last episode, we learned about higher order functions. Since functions are just values, like any other value in JavaScript, we can exploit that by making functions that take other functions as their arguments. And that is called a higher order function. We also learned to use a higher order function, filter. We learned that filter is a method on the array object that takes another function as its argument and uses that function to filter the array. In this episode, we're gonna learn about something new and awesome called map. Just like filter, map is another higher order function. Also like filter, it goes through an array, but unlike filter, it doesn't throw the objects away. Instead, it transforms them.
What?
What does it mean?
Let me show you. Take a look at this array. You might notice that I'm reusing the array from the previous video, but that is simply because arrays of animals is very, very common in enterprise-grade programming. But the problem is different this time around. We want to get an array of all the names of all the animals. This is super simple to solve with map, but before I do, I want to show you how we would solve this using a for loop. So let's check out what this does. Just console log the output, run it, and you see that this just logs out the names. The code is super straightforward. It just loops the animals array, and for each animal, it just picks the name property and it pushes it into the names array that we create on line 10. Now, let's do the exact same thing, but using map instead. I'll comment out the for loop here and keep it around for comparison purposes. Right, let's do this. Remember that I told you that map is a function on the array object, just like filter is. Map will take a callback function, just like filter does. The callback function will be passed each item in the animals array. But here is where map gets different from filter. Filter expected its callback function to return a true or false value that determined whether or not the item should be included in the array or not. Map will include all items in the array, but instead it expects the callback function to return a transformed object that it will put into the new array instead of the original animal. In this case, that will be the name. Like that. Now, let's save and run it and see if it produces the same output as the for loop. Bam! Exactly the same. Using map to return a subset of an object like this, where we return just the name property, is a very common usage pattern. However, since map just expects the callback to return any object, we can use it to create completely new objects. Let's run that. Ta-da! Fluffykins is a rabbit, Caro is a dog, Hamilton is a dog.
Yeah, they're getting it, don't.
But do you see how little code this is?
It is amazing!
I'm gonna put the for loop example next to the map example so that you can compare, and I'm gonna remove the extra code that we added to the map so that they are doing the same thing. Now, check here when I'm selecting the map example, and here in the lower left corner you see that this it's 66 characters. And when I select the for loop example, you see that it's 89 characters. That is like 30% more. Let me put it like in one line just to show you the size difference. I'm gonna pull this out a bit. That is a lot shorter. Short code is good because less code almost always means less bugs, but it gets even better. In ECMAScript 6, we're getting arrow functions. I'm gonna rewrite this using arrow functions. Arrow functions is a new, shorter, and better syntax for functions in ECMAScript 6. It looks like this. So, it's a bit shorter, but it gets better. If your function logic fits on one line, like in this example, you can just get rid of the return statement and the curly brackets. And this will, whatever statement is after the arrow function, will be implicitly returned. So let me comment out the stuff that we keep around for comparison and go back to the console and run this. Whoops! This won't work right off the bat because, as I said, arrow functions are a part of the ECMAScript 6 standard, and that is not fully implemented into browsers or Node yet. However, if you're running the latest version of io.js, you can just use the harmony arrow functions flag. And it works. If you're watching this video from the future, you don't have to do this. In functional programming, it's common to go even shorter and just shorten the variable names to x, like this. Bam. Let me put this next to the original for loop, just to show you how gorgeous this is. If you don't think this is absolutely beautiful, You just have no soul. You can't see beauty in the world. Just check this. This is 38 characters, and this is 90. And that concludes this informational computer science video about the higher order function map, which is part of this the series about functional programming in JavaScript. Next time, we will look at a classic higher order function called reduce. Don't miss it. Please subscribe if you like this. Also, follow me on Twitter @mbjme. Stay curious. See you next time.